Hey everybody, my name is John Stampone and I am the creative director of Kasper. Today I wanted to talk about ideas. I have some really unique ideas about ideas and I wanted to share them with you today because this is a mystery as old as time itself. Where does the genesis of an idea come from? How does it go from a blank thought to something that could be potentially revolutionary? I believe that ideas exist in the ether, and that what we need to do is set our minds to a frequency that we can receive them. So at my team, we are very receptive to everybody's ideas, and we've cultivated a culture that makes people feel free to express their ideas and to share them with each other. And this is huge, and I've worked for a bunch of different companies before where you felt timid, and like you might say something stupid, and that idea can get suppressed and die before it ever leaves your lips. And that is something that we are aiming to completely get rid of in the entire dental industry, but especially at Kasper, where we start first. So I even go up to like the interns, and I'll ask them, what's been on your mind? When you think about Kasper, and you're doing your daily activities and your routines, is there anything that you think could be better? Is there anything that you wish was a part of this that isn't right now? Is there anything that you haven't opened your mouth about that you want to share? There is no such thing as a stupid idea. There is stupid executions to ideas. And I want people to feel comfortable to be able to express them. So creativity, is a muscle just like anything else, and the more that you use it, the more that you'll be able to generate these ideas at a more consistent basis. And Kasper started from a lot of problems. Our founder is a dentist himself, and all of the problems from the front office, we began to create solutions for. So these ideas started off as just like, damn, our paperless forms suck. You know, and from that, that could be an entirely negative thought. But out of that little seedling provides you with the ability to do something about it and to make things happen. So I take that very seriously in my job, where you start with a blank sheet of paper that has endless limited possibilities. And it's taking that blankness, that nothingness, that void of space, and creating something that's going to change the industry forever. So when we start to sit down and we have these brainstorming sessions, I like to do them as early as possible in the morning. Because I personally believe that the closer that you are to the dream space, the closer that those ideas that can really change and are not bogged down by the ordinariness of everyday life are more likely to come about. So we'll have these meetings at 5 a.m. when everybody wakes up. And I think that there's less of that inner critic that's inside all of us to get in the way and hinder an idea from actually coming out. So we're there, everybody's tired, the alarm probably just went off 15 minutes ago, and somebody will come up with something that I've never heard before. Something that feels right. When you have an idea or hear an idea that actually feels right, your body has a physical expression of it. Some people call it goosebumps or goose flesh, but it's very similar to that. Mine is more of like an ASMRI experience where it almost feels like an egg yolk, like cracking and dripping down. I get the shivers a little bit, and I just know that what they said is not only going to work, but it's going to work incredibly well because of the procedures that we have in place to take an idea and turn it into a physical reality. And I'm just hoping that today from this conversation that you'll have the opportunity to discuss this with your team and sit down and make sure that they know that everybody's voice is going to be heard and that the input is extremely valuable. A company is not one person, it's a collective. And if you can make your collective feel that they have not only a voice within your company, but that they are part of the beating heart of your company, I believe that you're gonna go to extraordinary lengths and you'll just be unstoppable. So I hope you guys get a chance to talk with your team and I hope you get a chance to check out Kasper. Thank you.